योर फाउंडेशन कोर्स. सो कुछ कुछ चीजें हैं दो आई वॉन्ट टू गो फास्ट एंड आई थिंक यू ऑल नो दैट ऑल्सो. ओके एंड रिमेनिंग जो डिफिकल्ट पार्ट है वी विल कवर इन डिटेल. क्लियर चलेगा?
यस मैम,
हेलो. ओके
यस मैम.
ओके सो वी आर स्टार्टिंग हियर नाउ. सो यू कैन सी द ग्लाइकोसाइट. व्हाट डज इट मीन? कैन आई हैव अ रिप्लाई? हेलो. हेलो. व्हाट डज इट
इट
मीन
इज द
ग्लाइको?
बॉन्ड बिटवीन टू मोनोसैकेराइड्स,
यस इट्स द बॉन्ड
ग्लाइकोसाइड.
बिटवीन टू मोनोसैकेराइड. बट हाउ इट इज फॉर्म्ड?
बाय द कंडेंसेशन ऑफ अ वाटर मॉलिक्यूल.
एलिमिनेशन ऑफ
कंडेंसेशन
वाटर,
एलिमिनेशन ऑफ वाटर
मॉलिक्यूल.
मॉलिक्यूल बोलो.
कंडेंसेशन अल्कोहल.
यस कंडेंसेशन ऑफ. हियर यू कैन सी दैट दिस ओएच ग्रुप ऑफ एनोमेरिक कार्बन एटम रिएक्ट्स विद ईदर ओएच ग्रुप ऑफ अनादर मॉलिक्यूल और एनएच. मतलब अमाइनो ग्रुप और ओएच ग्रुप, व्हाट एवर अवेलेबल ऑफ अनादर कार्बोहाइड्रेट. नाउ दिस कार्बोहाइड्रेट डिड नॉट टू बी अ कार्बोहाइड्रेट इटसेल्फ, बट इट कैन बी अ अदर कंपाउंड ऑल्सो. ओके सो बॉन्ड विच इज फॉर्म इज नोन एज अ ग्लाइकोसिडिक बॉन्ड. ओके यू कैन सी हियर दिस ओ एच ग्रुप इज ठेवली का गाड़ी? ठीक. हाँ तो ओ एच ग्रुप हैज कंडेंसेस विद द ओ ऑफ अ एनोमेरिक कार्बन एंड देयर इज अ लिबरेशन ऑफ वाटर मॉलिक्यूल एंड दिस बॉन्ड इज नोन एज ग्लाइकोसिडिक बॉन्ड. नाउ द कार्बोहाइड्रेट पार्ट ऑफ दिस ग्लाइकोसाइड इज नोन एज अ सैकेराइड. सैकेराइड पार्ट इज नोन एज अ ग्लाइकोन वाइल अदर पार्ट इज नोन एज अ ग्लाइकोन. ठीक है. Now this is very important when we are going to study the disaccharide because all the characteristic of disaccharide it depends on the glycosidic bond and which functional group it involves. Okay, so here we are going ahead. So physiological important glycosides are very important because you may get a question of like add a note on important glycoside or it's a viva question and even it is a very MCQ question most frequently asked. So you can see glucovanillin, it is a vanillin plus D-glucoside. Now this is natural product and this mostly it is found in the food industry and used in the vanilla flavor. Now cardiac glycoside, this is very important, most frequently asked MCQ. So this is actually how cardiac glycoside, this is galactose plus digitonin and xylose. So this is a combination of these three compound. They are mostly known as a steroid glycosides. The name is digoxin or digitoxin. Now this and it has a glucocorticoid. Now importance is it stimulate cardiac muscle contraction. That's why it's very important. It's given in cardiac failure. Okay, now this is a plant indicus which is made up of glucose and indoxil. This is a dye type and used in the stain purpose. Now fluorescein is important cardiac glycoside. Sorry, it's not cardiac, but it's a glycoside which contains glucose and fluorescein as a glycone. Now this is this molecule, it causes renal damage to experimental animal, hence it is used for the studies in the animal. Okay, so this is all done. Now this I'll just give a passing reference. You know that what is the difference between phosphoric esters. So we found this type of esters in the nucleotide also. You can see this is a phosphate group attached to the 6 carbon compound and this is forming phosphate ester. Now when this is this OH at the second carbon is replaced, okay, we call it as a deoxyribose or deoxy this sugars. Okay, so you can see this is the example. I'm going very fast because I want to cover mucopolysaccharide, which is important part. Now oligosaccharides, now we are coming to oligosaccharides. Okay, so this oligosaccharide, hello, is it all okay? Hello.
Yes ma'am.
Yes ma'am.
Yes ma'am.
So now in oligosaccharide also we will mostly emphasize on the disaccharide. Okay, we know how they are classified. They are reducing and non-reducing. They are mostly sweet in taste and water soluble. Crystalline compound here. So you can see this disaccharides are formed by condensation reaction of two monosaccharide and the bond is glycosidic bond. Okay, can you name some disaccharide? Can you
lactose.
Name some
dietary? Sucrose, lactose, maltose,
sucrose, lactose and maltose. How do we classify them? Disaccharide?
Reducing and non-reducing.
Okay. So here we are. The three important type of disaccharide what we need to study is are maltose, lactose and sucrose. Out of this maltose and lactose, both are reducing. Sucrose is non-reducing. Okay. And all this because it has a different kind of glycosidic linkage. Now maltose, you know, it is formed during the digestion of starch. Even if you get in the infant formula, maltose hamare waqt rehta tha. Now it is the disaccharide made up of glucose and glucose. Okay. Lactose is glucose plus galactose. Mostly it is called milk sugar. So it is present in milk and the infant formula feed. Sucrose is known as a cane sugar or table sugar. It is made up of glucose and fructose. Okay. Now why you can see the maltose, which is the bond present. So this is, you can see two molecule of alpha D glucose. Now this OH of this anomeric carbon, it condenses with the OH group of other. Okay. So here you can see there is the removal of one water molecule and we get formation of maltose. Now, which is the bond present is alpha 1,4. Okay. So why it is reducing? Can you tell me why it is reducing?
It has free aldehyde.
Yes, free aldehyde drops. Second monosaccharide unit. Okay. Now important you have to remember this biochemical name. It is called alpha glucosyl 1,4 alpha glucose. Okay. So this is what is the name. On hydrolysis, same maltose can give you back two molecule of glucose. Now how we can differentiate lactose and maltose, because both give same reaction in the laboratory. Okay. We have discussed Mollisch, Benedict and Buffett. So, and even Selvinox, because these are all the three reactions would be same. So difference, we can differentiate this to lactose and maltose. This is just because of osazone crystal, and maltose gives you sunflower like osazone crystal. Now other disaccharides of importance is like, just like they are also made up of two glucose unit. But here you can see this is a isomaltose. What is the difference between maltose and isomaltose? Can you tell me? Hello.
Glycosidic linkage.
So which glycosidic linkage? So this is 1,6 glycosidic linkage. Okay. So this is the isomaltose. Mostly again, it is a product formed during the digestion of starch. Okay. And mostly this molecule will get when the branching at the branching point of starch. Okay. So you can see here. This is alpha 1,6 linkage and formed during the digestion of starch. Now another disaccharide is a cellulose. Now cellulose, can you see what is the difference between? You can see beta, again this is a,
beta,
yes,
beta 1,4
glycosidic linkage.
Yes. So, and how where you get beta glycosidic, beta 1,4 glycosidic linkage? In cellulose, you know?
Cellulose.
That's, yes, so that's why this cellulose is the product of digestion of cellulose by enzyme cellulase, which is not present in human being. Okay, so this is beta 1,4 linkage. So this you have to remember this name, isomaltose cellulose, mostly MCQ questions. Now coming to another reducing disaccharide, this is a lactose. You can see this is a galactose, epimer of glucose at fourth position. And this is a glucose. So you get here what is the bond present between is beta galactosyl beta 1,4 beta glucose, means one functional group of glucose is free here. So this is a reducing sugar. Now mostly it is a milk sugar. Now remember configuration here is both molecule are in beta configuration, but kuch books alpha configuration bhi mention karte hain. Okay. Now this you can see lactose is again hydrolyzed by intestinal enzyme lactase to glucose and galactose, and which is metabolized further as a glucose and galactose. Okay. Now intestinal enzyme lactase, which is synthesized by the brush border of intestine. So what will happen, like if there is any inflammation or like post viral inflammation, or even after taking antibiotic. Now in some persons it can be a inherited, means there is a inborn error where this lactase is not synthesized. Lactase being protein, it can have any defect in the synthesis. So whenever this lactase is deficient, what will happen? This lactose will not be digested, okay, and then it will remain in the gut, it will get fermented, and that's why it leads to the result of flatulence and diarrhea, and that disorder is known as a lactose intolerance. Now this is one of the differentiating factor you should know from the maltose. It is a osazone, and this osazone of lactose are powder or shipped. Okay, so this is, we have already discussed defect in beta galactosidase or lactase is a lactose intolerance. Remember, don't get confused, it is not a deficiency of lactose, but it is a deficiency of enzyme lactase. Okay, clear? Now such children doodh to nahi pacha pate lekin dahi pacha pate. Kyun? Because the curd contain lactobacilli, and this lactobacilli produces lactase, and this lactase will again help in the digestion of lactose. Now here one more terminology is the lactulose. Now lactulose is the similar to the, it seems like it is similar to the lactose, but you can see this is a synthetic disaccharide, and it's the monosaccharide units are also different, so galactose and fructose. Now important is, it is neither digested nor absorbed in the intestine, so it is again, it acts like just like a cellulose. Okay, so it will form the it will remain in the intestine, attract water, form the bulk, and increase the intestinal motility. So as intestinal motility is increased, it will cause the emptying time of intestine will be more, so absorption of certain compounds can be reduced. So that's why this is useful in the treatment of hepatic encephalopathy. Now here the blood ammonia levels jo badhte hai, that will be reduced because it converts ammonia into ammonium ion, and it reduces blood ammonia and NH4, and that's which is easily absorbed. Okay, so this is the importance of lactulose. Now coming to the last disaccharide, that is a non-reducing one, and this is a sucrose, which is a cane sugar, what we use mostly. So you can see here, what is the bond present here? Which is this molecule? Which is this molecule?
Glucose and fructose.
Glucose and fructose. Ye glucose hai ki ye glucose hai? Kaun sa glucose hai? Pehla ki dusra?
First one.
Okay, which configuration glucose is present?
Pyranose.
But it's alpha or beta form?
Alpha.
Okay. What about alpha. This fructose?
Beta.
Yes. So now you can see, and what's a bond present, which kaun sa bond dikh raha hai aapko, ye kaun sa carbon atom hai glucose ka? Yeah, glycosidic linkage So glycosidic linkage of sucrose is alpha 1 beta 2. Okay, now what is special in this both 1 and 2 carbon atom, one of glucose and two of fructose? What is special?
Anomeric carbon.
Yes, both are functional groups. No, so this H and OH, they are both derived from the functional groups. Okay, so here you can see there is a formation of alpha D glucosyl, means this is alpha 1 beta 2 linkage, and the chemical name of this molecule is alpha D glucosyl 1,2 beta D fructose, and this is a sucrose. Okay, so what is different when both the functional groups are involved in the glycosidic linkage, which property it will confer to this sucrose?
Non-reducing.
It will be non-reducing.
Yes, it would be non-reducing sugar. Yes, that's why. Okay, so simple here, you can see if maltose here, you can see this, this is unavailable, but here it is available, functional group. Same way, sucrose, both functional groups are not available because carbon number 1 and 2 are used in the glycosidic linkage. That's why sucrose is a non-reducing sugar. Remember, this can be a brief answer question. Why sucrose is non-reducing sugar? 2 marks ke liye aa sakta hai. So you should able to at least draw structure pura nahi to bhi, at least you should able to write what are the component and what are the linkage present and why it is not. Okay, now there is a concept which is known as invert sugar. Now invert sugar, what happened, we have seen that this sucrose is itself non-reducing, but if it is hydrolyzed by acids like HCl or enzyme like invertase or sucrase, so what will happen, this sucrose will get hydrolyzed into its constituent monosaccharide like glucose and fructose. Now here, if we consider the optical rotation of sucrose, now sucrose is a dextrorotatory plus 62.5, but after hydrolysis what will happen, it will be converted to alpha D glucose and beta D fructose. So you can see glucose has optical rotation of 52.5 and fructose has minus 22. So tell me what will be the resultant optical rotation of this compound then? This solution?
Levorotatory.
Yes. Levorotatory.
Yes. So you can see the sucrose, which was previously dextrorotatory, it has converted into levorotatory product. So this is known as an invert sugar. Okay. We even prove this reaction in the biochemistry jab aap 2 saal pehle jab hum practical lete the. Okay, so here you can see the specific sucrose test. This is known as even inversion test. So here you can see reagent alone is blue color. Now when with the glucose, because it's a reducing sugar, you get orange red color solution. Now sucrose ke sath kya hoga, when we treat the sucrose, it is non reducing, so this will not reduce this Benedict reagent, so it will be like that. But now if we do the inversion of test, how we'll do inversion, we take a sucrose molecule, add 20 drops of HCl, okay, usko heat karte hai hum. After heating we neutralize that solution again with 40% NaOH. Kyun neutralize karna zaruri hai, kyunki Benedict test is done in alkaline medium, so to achieve alkaline medium we again neutralize the solution and then we perform the same Benedict test with the hydrolyzer, and what we get the positive test. So this is known as inversion test and this is a specific sucrose test. So you should be ready for such a small things for brief answer questions. Clear? So here's, you should able to know what is the invert sugar and specific sucrose test. Okay, so let's move now to the important topic, that is a polysaccharide. So polysaccharide, when more than 10 monosaccharide units are there, so we call that compound as a polysaccharide. Now naturally when they are polymer, they will have bonds are more in number and free functional group is very negligible. Okay, so that's why such polysaccharides are non-reducing as a polymer, have a high molecular weight, and they are insoluble in water, tasteless and colloidal, and even they are not crystalline, so they are in the powder form. Aapne dekha hoga starch. Okay, so you can see this is polysaccharide. Now polysaccharides are again classified into 2 different classes, that is one is homopolysaccharide and one is heteropolysaccharide. Okay, so what can be the homopolysaccharide, what can be the heteropolysaccharide? Hello.
Same type of
monosaccharides
are the heteropolysaccharides.
So if they are the same type of monosaccharide unit, we call it as a homopolysaccharide. And when the monomeric units are different, we call it as a heteropolysaccharide. Now homopolysaccharide also, we have different type of monosaccharides. Like it can be made up of glucose only. It can be made up of fructose only, or it can be made up of derivative of glucose, like N-acetyl glucosamine only. Okay, so we can re-subclassify homopolysaccharide like glucosa, made up of glucose. Example of it is a starch, dextrin, glycogen, and cellulose. We will see how they are same and how they are different. Then fructosan is made up of fructosan is inulin. Okay, remember it's not insulin, it's inulin. Now glucosamine, polymer of glucosamine, it's a chitin. We will or chitin bhi bolte hai use. So we found in the insect exoskeleton of insects. Okay, so let's study starch. So you can see starch, it is made up of, it's in polymeric form. Starch, though it's a glucosan, homopolysaccharide, but they are divided into different type of forms are there. So you can see this is amylose and this is amylopectin. Now, can you tell me what is the difference between amylose and amylopectin? Diagrams are in front of you. Just you have to comment.
Amylopectin
is a branch.
Okay, linear branch. That is one difference. Or a linear branch.
Amylose is soluble.
Amylopectin has
16 linkage. We will come to bond. Bolo beta, suna hi nahi aa raha mujhe.
Amylopectin has 16 linkage while 14.
Amylopectin has 16, only 16 linkage?
16 and 16.
Okay. ठीक है और कुछ अब कुछ पता होगा तो दिस इज शोन इन द
अमाइलोज इज सॉल्युबल इन वाटर वेयर एज अमाइलोपेक्टिन इज नॉट
अमाइलोपेक्टिन इज इनसॉल्युबल ओके ठीक है क्यों इनसॉल्युबल है और क्यों अमाइलोज सॉल्युबल है व्हाई
लीनियर स्ट्रक्चर
ड्यू टू द ब्रांचिंग लीनियर एंड ब्रांच स्ट्रक्चर
लीनियर स्ट्रक्चर है मॉलिक्यूलर वेट कम रहा तो सॉल्युबल रहेगा ज्यादा रहा तो इनसॉल्युबल रहेगा है ना
यस
आई राइट यस सो यू कैन सी दिस अमाइलोज 20% ऑफ स्टार्च इट इज प्रेजेंट इन द फॉर्म ऑफ अमाइलोज यू कैन सी दिस इज अ लीनियर पॉलीमर एंड मोस्टली इट इज इन द हेलिकल फॉर्म बट रिमेंबर इट इज नॉट ब्रांच इट इज अनब्रांच मॉलिक्यूल Now most of the bond, most all the bonds present in this are alpha 1-4 linkage, which are the linear bond. Okay, so here you can see now molecular weight is around 60,000. Now if we compare it with the amylopectin, you can see this amylopectin is branch molecule, so it contains the alpha 1-4 linkage as well as alpha 1-6 linkage at the branching point. Its molecular weight is high and around you can see 80-90% of starch is contained in this. Now can you tell me, just have a guess, why there is importance of starch being stored in the polymeric form? Kya hoga? Kuch hoga? Okay. So you can see here
osmotic relation.
Yes. So kisme osmotic properties zyada hogi yahan ya yahan? Amylopectin is more osmotic active because it's a branch. It has more free ends, so it will get attached with the water. Okay, and this will this amylose can help to reduce this hygroscopic nature to some extent. Okay, so mostly starch is found in, remember, it's in plant. Okay, we don't find starch in the animal. Okay. So you can see this glucose this storage in the polymeric form minimizes osmotic effect. Okay, so this is about starch. Now hydrolysis of starch, mostly it is by the, it is in the form of like starch which is cut in the form of dextrin. Okay, now dextrin but let me clarify that this starch, being a high molecular weight, it reacts with iodine. And this iodine starch give blue reaction with the iodine. while this when it is cut, when it is hydrolyzed, it gives different type of dextrin. Now dextrin also reacts with the iodine, but depending on the molecular weight, it will form different type of color. So you can see this dextrin is, so dextrin first is formed, there is a formation of amylodextrin, then it is erythrodextrin, and then into the acrodextrin. So you can see this is a progressive hydrolysis of starch, and ultimately amylodextrin, the name of amylodextrin because it gives blue reaction with the iodine. Erythrodextrin will give you red solution, and acrodextrin will be colorless. But remember, still they are the product of starch. They are not a disaccharide yet. So they will show Benedict test negative. Okay, so this is the hydrolysis of starch, and this is important. You should know the steps of hydrolysis of starch. Okay, now very important molecule, this is a glycogen. Okay, how it is different from the starch, or can you explain, anyone can explain the structure of glycogen? Hello, jaldi jaldi bolo, I have only 15 minutes. Hello,
it is like a myelopectin.
It's more branched as
more branched.
Yes, four branch structure is mostly similar to the amylopectin. It is a compact molecule. You can see this is the colored format. This is a glycogen primer, which is which actually triggers synthesis of glycogen, and whole of the glycogen is built around it. Okay, now you can see this is the glucose storage polymer in animal. Mostly it is stored in liver and muscle. Structure is similar to amylopectin, but remember, branching is very very frequent. You can say every 8 to 10 unit there will be branching. Okay, so it has more amount of alpha 1,6 linkage. In starch you get branching at 15 to 20 molecular 15 to 20 monosaccharide unit, but here you get every 8 to 10 unit you will get branching. The why glycogen should be stored in this form, first thing is the growth, you know, high, more amount of carbohydrate molecule can be stored in the smaller space. That's why this is the compact arrangement of the glycogen. Okay, now this is highly branched structure enables enzymes, that is amylase, to act on it. Okay, and rapid space, so that release of glucose from glycogen is easier. Okay, and why we need this release of glycogen from the release of glucose from the glycogen, because this is a storage form of energy in the liver, but mostly it is important, it is stored in the muscles also. So at the result of exercise, this is a glycogen is the first molecule which will give you energy. Now remember, jaise starch kabhi bhi animal mein nahi hota, waise glycogen is never found in the plant. So glycogen is also known as animal starch, okay, but it's never found in the plant. Now which is this compound, you can see this is a green cell. So this is a polysaccharide mostly found in the cell wall, and that is the cell wall of the plant. So this is, you can see this is cell wall which is made up of cellulose fiber, and which when we again go on microsection, you will get a chain of polymeric molecule. Now this is also same as a starch, they are the homopolysaccharide of glucose, but here bond is different. Now bond is beta 1,4 linkage. Okay, it doesn't have any branching, but this is the linear chain of the cellulose, and they are attached to each other with the hydrogen bonds. Okay, so it forms the sheet of molecule. Here you can see the cellulose is one of the most important structural polysaccharide, and this is a major component of the plant cell wall. Now it is the polymer of beta D glucose. Now though this is not, because we don't have cellulase, so we cannot digest it, we cannot get energy from it. Okay, but still it has importance, because as just we discussed in the lactulose, this is not digested. Okay, so what will happen, it will remain in the gut, it will form, it will because of hygroscopic nature, it will form the bulk in the gut, and it increases the gastric motility, and thereby it decreases absorption of glucose and cholesterol. It increases motility, so they act as a stool softener. Then even it relieves the constipation, CVD and colon cancer, even diabetes mellitus and diverticulosis. So these are all important of cellulose. You make it question like importance of fiber, importance of cellulose, okay? And that 4-mark question can be asked, or even brief answer question can be asked on it. And the bond, the name of the bond, it is mostly asked in the MCQ also. Okay, so this is about the cellulose. Now, this is a chart, but I don't want to go in the details. So you can see, we can compare the 3 homopolysaccharide of glucose, that is the starch, which is stored in the polymeric form, amylose and amylopectin. Then the glycogen, which is known as the animal starch, and cellulose. Okay, so I'm not going into detail in that. Now let's move on to the another homopolysaccharide, that is the inulin. Remember, inulin and insulin is different. Inulin kya hai? Inulin is the homopolysaccharide. Insulin kya hai? What is insulin?
Hormone.
Yes, and inulin is a polysaccharide, and this is fructose. Mostly it is found in the bulbs like onion, garlic, chicory and dandelion. Now here you can see we don't have inulase enzyme. That's it is not digested, but it is, you can see it is filtered through the glomerulus and it is neither absorbed neither secreted by the tubules. So this is more important parameter for assessing renal function, and this inulin clearance test is equal to the GFR. So it is important to assess the GFR. So this we have discussed. Now coming to the one more polysaccharide you should know, dextran. Remember dextrin, dextrose, dextran and dextrin, these are three different. So dextrose was glucose, just 10% glucose. Dextrin we have studied in the like digestion of starch. This is a product formed by the digestion of starch having 8 to 10 molecules of glucose. Now dextran is little bit different. It is highly branched polymer of glucose. Now it contains alpha 1,4 and 1,6 linkage, and mostly it is a synthetic, it is produced by microorganism. Because of its high molecular weight, these dextran cannot skip, they cannot come out of the blood vessel. So in case of like whenever there is hypovolemia, blood pressure falls, this dextran are given in IV form, and this will act as a plasma volume expander. So it helps in the increase the blood pressure and to treat the hypovolemia. Okay, this we have seen. Now other heteroglycan, you can see this is the, you can see these are the mucus substances. So these are the agar. Mostly you will find in the culture, jab aap microbiology mein jaoge to aap bahut sare plates use karoge jisme most of the time this is the agar is used as a base for culture medium. So it is again heteroglycan. Mostly they are extracted from the seaweeds. They are composed of galactose and glucose unit. Now as they are not digested by bacteria, so this acts as a supporting medium. Bacteria will not eat it. We agar nourishment dalna hai to we add other part like glucose molecule or other sugars as a nourishment for the bacteria, but agar itself is not digested by. Okay, and they are also used in the certain specialized technique like immunoelectrophoresis or immunodiffusion, where we identify antigen or antibody depending on their reaction. Gum and pectin, they are non-cellulose fiber. We get them from the pulp, citrus fruit, apple, beet, carrot, and fruit conserving industry. Mostly they are used, and they are used in the industrial application. Okay. Now, very important out of this one is the chitin. Yeah, chitin is remaining. Now, mostly it is found in the exoskeleton of insect, that is crustacea. And this is again polysaccharide, but they are made up of N-acetylglucosamine. Now, what is N-acetylglucosamine? We have seen this is, you can see acetyl group and amino group attached at the second carbon atom, and it is bound. This N-acetylglucosamine, they are bind to each other with alpha 1,4 glycosidic linkage. Okay. Now coming to the heteropolysaccharide. Now glycoprotein and proteoglycan, मैं थोड़ा सा fast जाती हूँ ये, so that we should able to finish it. So glycoprotein, you can see proteins are more, glucose is less. So they are made up of small carbohydrate compound. Now proteoglycans, they are conjugated with the polysaccharide. Okay, so polysaccharide is higher in content. So carbohydrate content is more in the than this protein, and they are the glycosaminoglycan. They are known as the mucopolysaccharides. Mostly these mucopolysaccharides are made up of repeating unit of amino sugar and acid sugar, and they are known as a uronic acid. Acid sugar means uronic acid. So we will see how they are made up of. This is very, very important. You get short note, okay? MCQs, bahut sare aate hain, and Viva mein bhi bahut kuch pucha jata hai. So glycosaminoglycan, heteropolysaccharide proteoglycan, there are different terminologies for compound. Now how they are different, okay? So remember, they are polysaccharide, but they contain repeating unit of disaccharide. Clear? They contain repeating unit of disaccharide. Now with this disaccharide contain amino sugar or sugar acid. Now sugar acid is also uronic acid. So you can see this glycosaminoglycans are made up of these two type of units, disaccharide made up of uronic acid. Now uronic acid isme jo rahega, it can be either L-iduronic acid and glucuronic acid. Glucuronic acid humne padha hai. Now this iduronic acid is actually, idose is the epimer of glucose at the fifth position. Hai na, humne do mannose padha hai. Galactose padha hai. This is one of the more epimer idose, which is epimer at the fifth position with the glucose, and this acid of this acid derivative of this is known as the iduronic acid. Now amino sugar can be of two type, either D-glucosamine or D-galactosamine. Okay, so these are the sugar. Now remember, most of this glycosaminoglycan, they have charge group. Charge group, mostly the negatively charged group, so either sulfate or carboxylic group. So you can see here, so how they act. Now this is the structure of proteoglycan. Okay, you can see here, this is the hyaluronic acid is abundantly found mucopolysaccharide, in most of the tissue it is present. Now this to this there are the link protein attached, sorry, core proteins are attached with the link protein, and you can see other glycosaminoglycan like keratin sulfate and dermatin sulfate, they are attached. In sulfate, they are attached here, and together they form the this bottle brush like appearance. Okay, this is the peculiar structure of proteoglycan. Now, what is the importance? What are the important characteristic of this glycosaminoglycan? You can see this contain the they are very hygroscopic, as they contain the negatively charged unit. So they are mostly the hygroscopic. They attract water molecule and they form the gel-like consistency. One thing is because of charge, they are hygroscopic. Now even these charged molecule, they have repellent effect on with each other. So they form the mucinous or cushion-like, mucinous consistency. So that's why they have a cushion effect. They give cushion effect. And they help this structure or organ against the mechanical shock. Okay, even these compound, because they are present in extracellular matrix, they act as a molecular seal. Means they decide which compound will go out of the cell and which compound will not go out of the cell. Now, as I told you that because of negative charge, they repel each other. So they have resilience. Even they are compressed, they will be compressed for some time, but they will be again gone back to its original position. So that is, and because of this mucinous property, they have lubricating properties. Okay. Now example of you get here, you can see we have like hyaluronic acid, chondroitin sulfate A and B type, keratin sulfate, then dermatin sulfate, heparin and heparin sulfate. क्या कह रहते थे, which are the two main parts of this? Hello? Hello? Please mute your mic. कौन से दो components हैं? Hello? Which are two components of glycosaminoglycan? कौन से दो component हैं? Are you there?
uronic acid and amino sugars.
Okay. Uronic acid and amino sugar. Now we will see what are the, which is the uronic acid present in the present in this compound and what are the amino sugar. So you can see here. Now every this hyaluronic acid, you can see except hyaluronic acid, all rest of the glycosaminoglycan, they have sulfated group. So remember, first observation that all mucopolysaccharide except hyaluronic acid have sulfate group. Okay. Now here again, if you observe this dermatan sulfate, dermatan sulfate. No, this keratin sulfate. What is speciality? Kuch hai kya alag? Does it fit into the definition of glycosaminoglycan or is there any exception? Keratin sulfate?
Uronic acid ka form nahi hai glucose mein.
Yes, uronic acid is not present here. Instead of that, there is a galactose present. So remember these two things. All except hyaluronic acid contains sulfate. Then all except keratin sulfate contain uronic acid. Okay, it contain keratin sulfate contain galactose. Now, if we want to remember, we can remember like all H, the all H of this glycosaminoglycan will contain glucosamine. Okay, हमें ये भी याद रखना है कि किसमें glucosamine है और किसमें galactosamine. So all H like hyaluronic acid, heparin and heparin sulfate. Okay, और एक K जोड़ दो उसके साथ. So all H and one K. So they contain glucosamine. Okay. Now one more thing, where is iduronic acid is present?
Heparin. Dermatan sulfate.
सभी इसमें जो बचे हैं, most of them contain glucuronic acid. Okay? उसमें exception कौन सा है? Dermatan sulfate and heparin itself. Okay? So these are the exception. Like this glucosamine, all contain. That is N-acetyl glucosamine except dermatan sulfate and chondroitin sulfate. Okay, this contain galactosamine sulfate. Okay, now one more thing, you can see heparin itself name mein uske sulfate kahi bhi nahi hai, but it this molecule is itself highly sulfated. Okay, now one more exception of heparin from other glycosaminoglycan is that they are this heparin is secreted intracellularly, or this is present intracellularly, like it is present in the mast cell, it is present in the basophil and monocyte also. Okay, so this is, remember this ye to humne dekha heparin. Okay, so this is very important. You can remember, if you use this tricks, you can remember the composition of this glycosaminoglycan, and this is important because most of the time it is most frequently asked question. Now just I'll take I think 2 minutes. Ek hi minute hai mere paas. Okay, so you can see here hyaluronic acid. Remember, hyaluronic acid is the simplest one. It is present abundantly in skin, synovial fluid, bone, cartilage, vitreous humor and loose connective tissue, and they act as a lubricant and shock absorbent. Then it has a consistency, it maintains consistency of vitreous humor even wherever they are present. This important thing is that help in the cell to migration of cell and even helps in the wound repair. Now chondroitin sulfate A and B, they are present in cartilage, cornea, bone and tendons, present in skin and even CNS. So it is a tensile, it gives tensile strength to the tissue and responsible for maintenance of shape and structure. Now keratin sulfate, you can see it is again present in cornea, cartilage and loose connective tissue. Now important is, you can see keratin, so mostly it is, you can see cornea relate, so it keeps cornea transparent and maintains shape of cartilage. Now dermatan sulfate, derma is for skin, so mostly it is present in skin, blood vessels and heart walls. So it is important for pliability of skin, structure of heart wall, and responsible for formation of, yes, this is it. It is responsible for formation of atherosclerotic plaque in the blood vessels. Now heparin, you can see this is the anticoagulant. It is present in liver, lung and skin, and intracellularly it is present in mast cell and basophils. So you can see it is an important anticoagulant. That is one thing. Second thing is this helps in the activation of lipoprotein lipase. So it also helps in the metabolism of this lipoprotein. Okay. Now, heparin sulfate is a derivative of heparin, but remember it contains, you can see it contains, okay. So it is present in plasma membrane and Bowman capsule of glomerulus. So it acts as a receptor and participate in the cell growth, and it is responsible for selective permeability of cell membrane. Okay. So this was last slide. You can see the mucopolysaccharide. Doses. This is the deficiency of the enzymes which cleaves this mucopolysaccharide, and mostly they are the lysosomal hydrolysis enzyme. So when they are used because of deficiency of this enzyme, okay. So mostly dermatan sulfate and heparin sulfate, these are found in extracellular matrix. They are not cleaved properly, so they will accumulate in the tissues, accumulate in the organ, and even they are or die the remnants of it or partially hydrolyzed product are there, excreted in the urine also. And mostly you can see three disorders are there: Hurler syndrome and Sanfilippo syndrome. This is mostly autosomal recessive disorder, while Hunter syndrome is X-linked disorder. Now you can see mostly the clinical feature, it is the skeletal deformities, like the bones or the extremities are not properly maintained, and mental retardation. Hunter syndrome, the Sanfilippo syndrome is different in that it has more amount of mental retardation and less of the skeletal deformity. Now, if they are not treated properly, this may lead to the death. Okay. Now, remaining that glycoprotein and this, I'll send you the notes, and you can I think you can go through it. This is what are the artificial sweetener. Okay. I'll send you the notes. And now it's all about the carbohydrate chemistry. Okay. So if you have any doubt and any question, please contact me. I am always there to help you. Okay. Now you please join your foundation course rapidly. Leave this meeting and join to the foundation course. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you. Please join fast.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
So leave fast.